Now, with the DAP, let's talk about that. Mm-hmm. Of course, this administration tried to innovate by making sure spending was faster. You know, you don't allot funds and it sits out there. There's no movement. And yet you were sued. I mean, well, you have some petitioners that have sued you for DAP. And you have the Supreme Court striking down four aspects of DAP.
Yeah, well, first of all, let me state, because, you know, in these past few days and weeks, DAP has been discussed in the context of anti-corruption. But really, Karen, just, you know, insofar as me and the President, President Aquino, is concerned, this has never been an issue, you know, insofar as the Supreme Court deliberations. And even now, with the one, you know, a complaint being filed in the Ombudsman, there's never been allegations that, you know, personal gain was involved, fraud was involved. It's just that there are, you know, constitutional and technical issues that were involved. Now, number two, it is not true that DAP, the totality of DAP, was declared unconstitutional by the courts.
I'm right. Only certain, four. Did I say four?
Four. Only certain acts and practices within DAP were considered unconstitutional. But generally, even the Supreme Court conceded that DAP did the country good. In fact, you know, when we started in 2010, the first thing that we did was to clean the house. Because as the President said, you cannot continue spending money when the pail is leaking. So we had to plug those leakages. But the year after we implemented DAP, because in 2011, because of all that house cleaning, GDP only grew by 3.6%. Yeah. But the year after, when we implemented DAP, it grew by 6.8% in 2012. And in 2013, it went even further to 7.2%. Yeah. And then the controversy hit. You know, so really, this program of accelerating expenditure and making sure that funds that are sitting idle are utilized for priority programs worked. Mm-hmm.